Hi students, so in the previous class I have discussed the third question of final accounts. So in this class I am going to discuss with the fourth question. Okay, once you see the question, from the following trial balance of Manoj and Sons traders, prepare trading P&L account and balance sheet for the year ended 31st March 2018. Okay, so from this trial balance we have to prepare the balance sheet over there. Okay, so once you see what he has given in the trial balance, first you see the debit balances. So here purchases he has given. Purchases we have to take it in trading account debit side. Salaries P&L account debit side. Wages trading account debit side. Buildings assets. Carriage on purchases trading account debit side. Gas, coal and water trading account debit side. Office expenses P&L account debit side. Commission P&L account debit side. Debtors asset. Opening stock P&L account debit side. Machinery, okay, machinery asset. Insurance we have to take it in P&L account debit side. Bank balance asset. Bills receivable asset. Cash asset, okay. Furniture is also asset. Okay, these are the debit balances. Now let us see the credit balances. Sales trading account credit side. Creditors balance sheet liability. Capital liability. Interest received P&L account credit side. Bills payable liability. Bank overdraft liability. Outstanding rent is liability. Outstanding rent, it is not given in adjustment, it is given in trial balance. So only once it will appear, okay, only once it will appear, so that we have to take it in balance sheet liability. So outstanding rent is given in trial balance, means we have to take it in balance sheet liability side. Okay, now let us discuss regarding the adjustment. Okay, so first adjustment, what he has given, once you see ma, first adjustment he has given closing stock. What he has given? Closing stock. So fourth question, so first you see the adjustments over there. So first adjustment, what he has given? Closing stock. So each and every adjustment will appear twice. Each and every adjustment will appear twice. So closing stock, actual closing stock value is how much? 9000. That 9000 first we have to take it in trading account credit side. Where we have to take? Trading account credit side. Next time it will appear in balance sheet. Okay, it will appear in balance sheet asset side. It will appear in balance sheet asset side. Okay, next coming to the second adjustment, outstanding salaries he has given. What is the second adjustment here? Outstanding salaries. So outstanding salaries is how much? 1000. Sorry, outstanding salaries is how much? 1000. Okay, this 1000 will appear twice. Okay, once you have to add to the P&L account, you have to take it in P&L account, and you have to add to the concerned item. We have to add to the concerned, nothing but we have to add to the salaries. This 1000 you have to add to the salaries in P&L account, which side? Debit side. Next time it will appear in balance sheet. Okay, balance sheet liability. Balance sheet liability. Okay, next coming to the third one. Third one is prepaid insurance. What is third one? Third one is prepaid insurance. Nothing but prepaid expenses. So prepaid insurance is how much? 100. Prepaid insurance is how much? 100 he has given. So prepaid insurance, first we have to take it in P&L account debit side, and we have to deduct from insurance. We have to deduct it from insurance. Next time it will appear in balance sheet. Okay, balance sheet assets. Same adjustments I am explaining. Okay, in the past two questions also I have explained same adjustments. So again in this question also we have a same adjustments over there. So prepaid insurance 100, P&L account debit side we have to deduct, and next time it will appear in balance sheet asset side. Okay, next coming to the fourth adjustment. Fourth adjustment what he has given means create 5% provision on debtor bad debts he has given ma. See the fourth adjustment, create provision for bad debts, 5% provision for bad debts he has given. Okay, so this provision for bad debts we have to calculate on debtors. Provision for bad debts we need to calculate on debtors. Okay, so debtors is how much in the question? Debtors is 25,000. On this 25,000 you have to calculate 5%, means 5/100. Okay, see ma, provision for bad debts 25,000 is there. Debtors is 25,000. On this debtors you need to calculate 5%. You need to calculate 5%. 00 cancel, 2 zeros cancel, 250 into 5. 250 into 5 is how much? 1250. 1250. So 1250 first where we have to take P&L account, debit side you have to take. Which side you have to take? My P&L account, debit side you have to take. Next time balance sheet. Okay, next time balance sheet asset. We have to minus it from debtors. We have to deduct it from debtors. Okay, got the point? I think so. Provision for bad debts 5% he has given. Okay, 25,000 into 5% you calculate. So 5 by 100, 2 zeros 2 zeros cancel. 250 into 5 is how much? 1250. So 1250 you have to take it in P&L account debit side. Next time balance sheet asset side you have to deduct it from debtors. Okay, that is the fourth adjustment. Next, coming to the fifth adjustment. Fifth adjustment, what he has given, once you see depreciation on furniture, he has given depreciation on furniture. Okay, depreciation on furniture, how much he has given? 200 he has given. Ma, okay, 200. First, you have to take it in P&L account debit side. You have to take it in P&L account debit side. Next time, balance sheet. Okay, next time, balance sheet asset, you need to deduct from furniture. You have to deduct it from furniture. You have to deduct it from furniture. And here two depreciations he has given. Fifth adjustment, he has given two depreciation. Next one is depreciation on machinery also he has given. Depreciation on machinery 600, direct amount he has given. So this 600 also, what you have to do? You have to take it in P&L account debit side. And next time balance sheet. Okay, balance sheet asset. Balance sheet asset you have to deduct from machinery. 600 you have to deduct it from machinery. Okay, next coming to the sixth adjustment. Sixth adjustment he has given outstanding wages. Sixth adjustment he has given outstanding wages. So outstanding wages, how much he has given? 1200 he has given. Outstanding wages 1200 he has given. Ma, so 1200, what you have to do? Wages you need to take it in trading account now. So you have to take this outstanding wages in trading account debit side. You have to add to the wages. You have to add to the wages. Next time it will appear in balance sheet. It will appear in balance sheet liability side. It will appear in balance sheet liability side. Okay. So once you see all these adjustments, closing stock, okay, trading account credit side, balance sheet asset side, outstanding salaries. Okay, 1000 rupees you have to add to the salaries in P&L account debit side, and it will appear in balance sheet liability. Prepaid insurance, it will appear in P&L account debit side. You have to deduct from insurance. Next time it will appear in balance sheet asset. Provision for bad debts on debtors, you need to calculate 5%. So 5% he has given in the question. So 25,000 into 5%, you will be getting 1250, that is 1250. This 1250 you have to take it in P&L account debit side, and balance sheet asset side you have to deduct from debtors. Okay, next fifth adjustment, depreciation on furniture and depreciation on machinery, both are there. So both you have to, depreciation of furniture and depreciation of machinery, both they will appear in P&L account debit side, and next time in balance sheet asset you have to deduct from concerned asset. Next, outstanding wages he has given, that is 1200. So this 1200 you have to take it in trading account debit side. You have to add it to the wages. Next time it will appear in balance sheet liability. Okay, these are the adjustments. Now we'll prepare the accounts, trading account, P&L and balance sheet. Okay, so first we'll prepare the trading account. Okay na, so what we have to take, ma? Opening stock. As usual, you have to take first opening stock. You have to take opening stock. Okay, see here, first you have to take opening stock. Opening stock, how much he has given in the question? 6000. Okay, next purchases. So here in case of purchases, we doesn't have a returns. So directly purchases, you take it in amount quarter column. Okay, next two wages. Wages, how much he has given? 7800. After that, wages, we have a outstanding wages na. So take it in inner column. Okay, add outstanding wages. Add outstanding wages. Outstanding wages, how much he has given? 1200 he has given. How much he has given? 1200. So total it will be 9000. Okay, after wages, next what we have? Two carriage on purchases. So carriage on purchase is how much? 400. Two gas, coal and water. Gas, coal and water, how much it is? 200. Okay, so trading account, we have taken all the items in debit side. Next credit side, buy, sales. Okay, sales is how much he has given? 52,000. Here in case of sales also we doesn't have any returns. So sales is how much? 52,000. Next, by closing stock. By closing stock. So closing stock is how much here? 9,000. Closing stock is how much? 9,000. So all the items we have taken now. Now add it. Okay. What we have to do? We have to add. So here debit side total is how much? 61,000. Debit side total is 61,000. Okay. And credit side total 6,000, 20,000, 9,000, 400, 200. Add ma. You will be getting 35,600. This total will be 35,600. So credit is more. Okay. Credit is more. So the balance which you are getting, that is to gross profit. To gross profit. Okay. Gross profit carried down. To gross profit carried down. See ma. Credit side total is 61,000. Okay. That 61,000 you have to take both the sides. Okay. Debit side total is 35,600. You 61,000 minus 35,600 you do. You will be getting gross profit, that is 25,400. Okay. This gross profit you have to transfer to P&L account. This gross profit you have to transfer to P&L account. Okay. Now let us start doing the P&L account. After completing the trading, now do the P&L account. Okay. First, what we have to do is you have to bring gross profit this side. By gross profit brought down. By gross profit brought down 25,400. First, you have to take the gross profit. After that, we have to take the P&L expenses and incomes which are related to the P&L. We have to take. First, we will take the expenses. What he has given? First, two salaries he has given. What he has given? Salaries. For salaries, we have adjustment. So, 5,000 plus add outstanding salaries. Add outstanding salaries. Outstanding salaries is how much? 1,000. So, 5,000 plus 1,000. So, total it is 6,000. Next, office expenses. To office expenses. So, office expenses is how much? 600. Next, to commission. Okay. So, commission. It is 300. So office expenses is 600. Commission is 300. Next we have insurance. For insurance we have an adjustment to insurance. Okay, to insurance. Okay, insurance how much he has given? 400. From that 400 minus prepaid insurance. Minus prepaid insurance. Okay, so prepaid insurance how much he has given in the question? 100. So leftover balance is 300. After insurance, so nothing is there in debit balances. Coming to the credit balances, we have interest received. So by interest received. Okay, interest received is how much? 2,000. Okay, now we have to see the adjustment. In adjustment, what we have? To provision for doubtful debts or bad debts. To provision for bad debts. In adjustments, we have calculated 1,250. Okay, afterwards what is left over? To depreciation on furniture. To depreciation on furniture, that is 200. Next, to depreciation on machinery. To depreciation on machinery, that is 600. Okay, so now all we have taken. So here, credit side is more, that is 27,400. Credit side is more, that is 27,400. Debit side got total 9,250. Debit side total is, after adding all this, you got 9,000. We got 9,250. So what we have to do? 27,400 minus 9,250 you have to do. Then you will be getting net profit. Then you will be getting a net profit. 27,400 minus, deduct all these things. Then you will be getting a net profit. Okay. That net profit is how much? Means 18,150. Net profit is how much? 18,150. This net profit you have to transfer to the balance sheet. Nothing but you need to add to the capital. This net profit is a balance figure. Net profit is a balance figure. Credit amount minus debit amount you do, you will be getting a net profit, that is 18,150. This 18,150 you have to add to the capital in balance sheet. Okay. Now let us do the balance sheet. First liability side you see ma. Capital. So capital how much he has given in the question? Capital 30,000 he has given. Take it in inner column. for this add net profit. Here we doesn't have any drawings. If drawings are there, you need to deduct. So net profit is how much? 18,150. Add it. So 48,150. Okay. After that, next, what are the creditors? Okay. Creditors. Creditors is how much? 18,500. Next, bills payable. So bills payable is 5,200. Next, bank overdraft. Bank overdraft is how much? 5,500. Next, outstanding rent. Outstanding rent is how much? 800. Okay, after that, adjustments. Outstanding salaries. Outstanding salaries, 1,000. Okay, after that, outstanding wages. Outstanding wages is how much? 1,200. So everything we have taken. Now add liability side. Next, coming to the assets. Assets, what we have? First, buildings. Okay, so buildings is how much? 24,000. Next, debtors. Okay, for debtors we have an adjustment. So debtors is how much he has given? 25,000 he has given. 25,000 minus provision for bad debts. So provision for bad debts is how much? 1,250. Okay, 1,250. 0. 10 minus 5, 5. 9 minus 2, 7. 4 minus 1, 3. So 23,750. Next, after that, what we have? Machinery. Okay, for machinery we have an adjustment. Machinery is 12,000 minus depreciation. That is how much? Depreciation? 600. So 11,400. After machinery, what we have? Bank balance. Bank balance. Okay, so bank balance is how much? 4,000. Bank balance is 4,000. Next, what he has given? Bills receivable. Bills receivable is 2,000. Cash is how much? 1,300. Next, furniture. So furniture is 5,000. We have adjustment, that is depreciation. Depreciation is 200. So 4,800. Next, closing stock. Closing stock. Okay, closing stock is how much he has given in adjustments? 9,000. After closing stock, next, what we have to take it here? Prepaid insurance is there. In adjustment, what we have? Prepaid insurance. So prepaid insurance is 100. So now add both the sides, ma. You will be getting 80,350. You will be getting 80,350. Okay, add both the sides. You will be getting 80,350. Okay, 80,350. That means the balance sheet total. Both the sides you will be getting 80,350. So this is the fourth question. Okay, I think you have understood this. Clear? Thank you.